Are you ready to have a good time? All right, my friend here tomorrow, he's going to be at Praise on the Hill in Harlingen at the soccer complex. If you want to see more of him, make sure you get out there tomorrow and see him. Now, he's coming in for an event tomorrow, but he said he's willing to come here today just for you because he likes pancakes, and he said, I want to go to Perkins Middle School. Now, let me tell you a little bit about my friend. This guy's a professional basketball player. He played with the San Antonio Spurs. He even went head-to-head with my idol, Michael Jordan. But he spent most of his career with the Harlem Globetrotters, where he was twice named Mr. Globetrotter. He's a two-time All-American in college. He's been on MTV Cribs twice. Can I get your attention up here? Can you keep quiet for me? Keep quiet. He's been on MTV Cribs twice. He's been on Oprah. He's been on BET Comedy. It is my honor to introduce my friend, Melvin Adams.
What's up? What's up? Hey, first of all, I just want you to know your principal is good looking. That's all I'm saying. Yes. Can you turn it down a little bit? Just a little bit. Now, when I came into your school, your principal came out, the wind was blowing. She was like, welcome to my school. I love it. Before I get started, we have some special guests. I just got to give some shout outs to all my special guests. First of all, I want to thank your principal, J-Lo. Thank you, J-Lo. Yes. Right there in the red, I want to thank Diego, Dora's cousin, grown up. You know what I mean? Right there. Yes. Who else? I want to thank your coach, Van Diesel. Yes. 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 This is amazing. Yes. Yes. I want to thank the Latino Obama right there. Thank you, brother. Appreciate it right there. Yes. Yes. Now, before I get started, let me just see if you guys are with me. Let me see if you're with me. So clap once if you hear me. Clap twice if you hear me. Clap three times if you're ugly. One brother right there. I ain't ugly. How many of you here have a dream? How many of you have a dream? Okay, everybody else want to go to jail. Okay, great. All right. How many of you believe it doesn't matter where you come from, what matters is where you're going? Doesn't matter where you come from, what matters is where you're going. I have a friend, he's 6'4", 300 pounds. You know, he is just the black version of Shrek. Yeah. The only difference between this brother is he didn't marry Fiona, but he had a dream to play in the NFL, and the NFL stands for not for long. Yeah. He grew up in the great state of Florida, but he made a lot of bad choices. Somebody say bad choices. That's good. If you hold it in, you're going to fart. Let it out. Good. Choices. All right. He found himself as a security guard at a public school. They didn't give him a gun, didn't give him mace. They gave that brother a flashlight. And can you imagine a 6'6" black guy walking to your school talking about, I see you. I see you. And he looked in the mirror and he said, you know what? I'm not living my dream. And that's why I tell girls, if you're a girl, every morning you need to wake up, you need to look in the mirror, you need to tell yourself this. If you're white, you need to go, oh my God, I'm so amazing. Yeah. If you're Hispanic, muy, muy bonita, caliente. Yeah. If you're a black girl, hey, for real though, hey. Yeah. If you're Asian, get ready for photo now, whatever you do. He looks in the mirror and he's watching Monday Night Football with his brother, right? And haters are born every 2.4 seconds. They go to Hater Middle School. They drink Haterade. They watch Hater Vision. And he looks over his brother. He says, hey, man, by this time next year, I'm going to be in the NFL. His brother, man, he said, man, stop lying. You're a security guard. They didn't even give you a gun. They didn't give you mace. They gave you a flashlight with no batteries. But after the game was over, this brother went out. He started working out. Can you imagine a 6'6" guy running through your neighborhood sounding like Darth Vader? His lips were so big, it looked like two pancakes fighting over syrup. But the next year, he was starting for the Buffalo Bills on Monday Night Football. So let me tell you my story. I grew up as a kid with a dream to play professional basketball. My daddy was 6'6". My brothers are 6'8", 6'7", 6'2". My mother was 5'3". And my aunts were Ewoks on Star Wars, but I had a dream. Yes. I was the shortest, but I was also the cutest. What's up? Anyway, my mom was the typical black mother. I didn't like going to school, so I'd wake up and be like, Mama, I ain't going to school. What time are we leaving? Yeah. And if you're Hispanic, it's the chancla. Oh my God. And if you're white, time out, Billy. But anyway, my daddy and Osama bin Laden were the two best hide-and-go-seek players I've ever known. My daddy was the best hide-and-go-seek player I've ever played against. When I was in high school, because my dad wasn't in my life, I was an angry kid. I got in trouble a lot, and the principal said, you know what? We're going to call your daddy. I said, you found him? Yeah. So I grew up short. My mother, I'm going to tell you more of my mom. I grew up in poverty. I tell people we were so broke, if you tried to rob us, you'd be practicing. Yeah. We were so poor, we couldn't even afford the OR. We was po. Y'all know the cologne obsession? We had to buy repossession, you know what I mean? Polo shirts is like a guy on a horse. We had to buy like a drunk dude on a mule. So I grew up short. I even had a hard time in relationships. I remember dating a girl in high school with a lazy eye. And every time I look at it, I'd be like, but that didn't even last long because I found out she was seeing somebody on the side. But there were obstacles in my life. Now, I could have made all the excuses, but I didn't. I began to shoot about 3,000 jump shots every day. I ran 3 miles every day. I used to drive my mother's car on a major freeway in Houston, Texas at 4 o'clock in the morning, open up the door, dribble the ball while I was going 5 miles an hour until I could do it going 10. Had an opportunity to go to college in California. Well, the gas prices were so high, the Crips and the Bloods was riding together. You know what I mean? Got to go to college, got to be a two-time All-American. I led the nation in scoring my junior year. I got to go all over the world. Got to go to Africa. Africa. I got to go to France. Bonjour, oui, oui, pipi, ho-ho. Yeah. And I got to live my dream. So I wanted to pause real quick because I'm going to need a little help. So I'm going to get this, where is brother at? The tall guy. What a big tall dude. Seventh grade. Come here. You know you're tall when you wake up and you see the Lord. What's up? If you're a girl and you date him, you got to get a running start. Just, I love you. I love you. So we're going to get Latinos on steroids. Okay, let me get, where's the little, it was a little bitty girl. She had like dimples. She was real little. Yeah, right here. Dora. Come here. Dora the Explorer. I love you. Yes, Dora. So you're going to come over here. Steroids. Okay, right here. His brother's tall. Okay. We're going to get Dora. So we got Latinos on steroids. Got Dora. Okay, let me get Taylor Lautner when he was a baby. Yes. Okay, yes. It's real easy. It's real easy. You please? Yes. Can he come? Yes. Don't be scared. You're going to fart. You're going to hold in. Yeah. Okay, he's scared. Okay. Can I get the girl here? Katy Perry. Thanks for coming, Katie. Okay, yes. All right. Okay, let me see. Okay, let me get, you know, white kids here? Just all Latinos. Okay. Okay. Harry Potter. Let me get Harry Potter. Okay. Got Harry Potter, Katy Perry, Dora, and Latinos on steroids. Okay, can I get the girl right there? Like she's in church. Yes. Okay. Yes. Mother Teresa. Okay. Okay, so I got her. Okay, so I got Dora the Explorer, Katy Perry, girls hugging girls, Harry Potter, and Latinos on steroids. Let's see, we need one more boy. Okay, yes, can I get the Latino J.J. Watt? Yes, right there, yes. Come on down, yes. All right. Sweet, that's going to be awesome. Okay. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to teach, let me rephrase it, I'm going to attempt to teach these young people how to do some tricks. Now, I don't know how it is here on this side of Texas, but in Houston, my mother always taught me that girls go first in everything. So we had to open the doors for the girls. We couldn't eat till they ate. Because, you know, girls get mad, like, you know what I mean? But if you give them some chocolate, they'll be cool. Like, is that Hershey's? All right, so we're going to get the girls. We're going to get Shorty right here. Right here. Okay, we're going to get Dora the Explorer right here. Yeah, you're gonna get behind her, swipe her, no swiping, okay? Okay, Mother Teresa right here. JJ Swat right here. Harry Potter right here. And steroids right here, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do these tricks for not just one person, but 2, 3, 4, 5 and a half people, all right? And I have two rules. Everybody say two rules. Rule number one, you see anything you like, you clap. Rule number two, you see anything you don't like, you still clap. Cool, all right. Now, I was watching all of you girls, and all of you girls are beautiful. Tell me something I don't know. But all you girls have hands, not just to slap your brother every now and then. But you have hands so you can catch the ball. Because most girls all over the world will sit there like, ah! That's a ball. It's not a bullet. You'll live to see another day. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to save the best for last. So you're going to go last because you're awesome. And your name is?
Marcy.
Marcy.
Okay, Marcy. Okay, Marcy, you're going to stay there, and you're going to do everything I do, and we believe in you, all right? So, Marcy, the ball's going to come at you. You got to catch it. If it hits you, I'm going to laugh, but I'm going to help you. You know what I mean? So, Marcy, what you're going to do, Marcy, you're going to round the waist twice, this leg twice, fake the pass, push it down, off your knee. Ready? Okay. Oh, here we go. Marcy, so, round the waist twice, this leg twice, fake the pass, push it down, off your knee. You got it, Marcy. So you go round the waist. There you go. Good job, Marcy. You're amazing. Look at you. You go, girl. Then round that leg. You're doing good. Okay. Oh, the baby leg. Okay. There you go. Then you're going to fake the pass. Okay, that was good. You scared me. That was good. And then you're going to kick it to Tate. Tate. Yeah. Tate. Good job. Nice. Give it up for my girl, Marcy. Good job, Marcy. You can sit back, Marcy. You did good. All right, this is?
Aisha.
Aisha. Okay, Aisha, okay. Aisha, you're gonna do the same thing Marcy did. It's gonna be a little different, a little easier, because you are the woman superstar. All right, so you're gonna go around your waist twice. This leg, here. She good, she's like, I got this, black man, I got this. I got this. Okay, there you go, good job, there you go. Nice, there you go. Then around that leg, you're doing good. Then the other leg. You killed a mosquito. Wow. Okay, now, you're going to turn sideways towards your boyfriend. What's up? Okay,
I don't have a boyfriend.
You're going to raise your right leg up. There you go. You're going to hold it with this hand. Your nails look good. You got them done?
No.
Okay, so you go hit it to me with this hand. Don't kill Charlie's Angels. Here we go. It's like, wait, yeah. Good job. Nice. Give it up for my girl, Abigail. Good job.
Abigail.
Abigail, what is it?
Aisha.
Aisha, my bad, Aisha. Now, this is?
Frank.
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 Okay. Frank, real easy trick, Frank. What you gonna do, Frank? You're gonna roll the ball just like this. Round the back, knee, foot, back. Frank was like, orale, viva la raza. Here we go. Frank, here we go. So Frank, you're gonna roll it here. I'm gonna talk you through it. Okay, that's kind of nasty, but we'll roll that. You're gonna round the back. You're doing good, Frank. There you go. Round the back. There you go. Good job. There you go. Nice. Off the knee. You're doing good. Okay. Okay, this brother playing kickball. Okay. Then you're going to go around the back. You're doing good, Frank. There you go. Then off your elbow. Straight! Okay, hold on. He did it like Richard Simmons. I'm a pony. Straight! Machismo! Straight! You go, yes. Straight! Oh, that wasn't even better. Give it up for my boy, Frank. Frank, good job, baby. Frank, you're my hero, man. Now, this is?
Eric.
Sound like Chewbacca. Luke.
Eric.
Okay, Eric. Okay, Eric, real is a trick, Eric. What you gonna do? Let's spin it here. Eric is like. No, Eric, that's kind of hard. We're gonna give Eric an easy trick. Eric, what you gonna do? So, Eric, don't be twerking. You know what I mean? You know. So, Eric, you're rolling by under the chest, around the back, twice. There you go. Eric needs some super glue. Oh, my gosh. Here we go, Eric. You the man. So, you're going to roll on the chest, Eric. You the man. Ooh, Lord. Here we go. Oh, my God. Okay, that was good. That was good. Round the back. You're doing good, Eric. There you go. Okay, you got to stop eating them tortillas. You know what I mean? That was kind of, got to go with the corn. All right, then you're going to bounce it. Not too, yay! Okay, okay, anybody got some suction cups? Here you go, Eric. You can do it. You're going to bounce it real, like take your time. Okay, you're almost there, Eric. Think about your, okay, did he do the stanky leg? Was that the stanky leg? Okay. Here we go. You got it, Eric. Did he just do the stanky leg? Was that? Okay. Here we go. You can do it, Eric. We believe you can fly. Hey! There you go. Nice. Keep it there. Then you're going to just hit it like that. Good job. Nice. Give it up for my boy, Eric. Nice, Eric. Now, this is
Arnold.
Arnold. Arnold, really is a trick. Arnold, what you going to do? No, we're not going to do that because if it got in Arnold's hair, we'd lose this ball for about 2 weeks. So, Arnold, what we're going to do, you're not going to do that, Arnold. What you're going to do, you're going to turn towards that way, not now, but when you're about to do your tricks, round the waist twice. Now, Arnold, don't fart because you'll kill Miss Hernandez. So you're going to round the waist twice, pop, lock, and drop. So round the waist, yeah. Yeah, don't fart, though. Here we go. Okay. Good job. Good job, Arnold. You're a hero, Arnold. Now, what's your name?
Lynetha.
Okay, this is Lynetha. Lynetha, what I'm going to do, man, you've been working out. You're strong, girl. Okay. What you benching, like 200? Hey, okay. So, Lynetha, what I'm going to do is I'm going to spin the ball on your finger. Do you believe that I can spin the ball on your finger? Okay, that was real motivating. We're going to ask her again. Do you believe?
Yes.
Yes, good. 90% of success is just believing that you can do it. Now, Lynetha, before I do it, there's a couple of things wrong with your finger. Okay, we got to file that down because you could stab somebody in China. Okay, that's a long, okay. Was that peanut butter? Okay, here we go, Lynetha. Tell you my story. See, Mr. PJ, or George Bush, he told you a little bit about me, but he didn't tell you everything. So I'll tell you my story. I've been on Sister Sister. I've been on Little Nicky with Adam Sandler. Been on BET Comic View, HBO Comedy, Oprah. Been on MTV Cribs twice. And when you read my bio, you go, wow, that's a great story about a poor black kid who grew up in poverty but made his dreams become a reality. But let me tell you the true story about my life. First of all, let me tell you about my mother. This was my mother. If I got an 89, my mother would cuss me out because I should have got a 90. If I got a 90, she'd cuss me out because I should have got a 91. And if I got a 100, she wouldn't say nothing because that's what I should have got. I played football. I remember scoring 4 touchdowns. My mother said, you would have had 5 if you wouldn't have fumbled the ball. So you want to know why I shot 3,000 jump shots every day? You want to really know why I ran 3 miles? Because I thought if I could score more points or make more money, maybe my mother would love me more. She grew up as a kid. My mother never told me she loved me. I never heard that. It was actually 11 years ago was the first time in my life that I ever heard from my own mother that she loved me. My dad was a cop. He was a cop. And he would come home and he would hammer 6 nails in a piece of wood. He would turn the sharp points. He'd beat my mother. He'd beat my brothers. And then he would beat me. And there are many times my dad would make me watch him, make my mom get on her knees on a gravel street, and he would beat her with a water hose. And as a kid going to school every day, see, nobody knew that because, see, boys, we hold everything in. Our butt be so tight, Moses couldn't part it. And I'm coming to school every day, and I'm thinking about suicide, if I can be quite honest with you. I hated authority because every authority in my life let me down. My dad made promises. He never owned up to those promises. And I was coming to school every day thinking about suicide. But there were two teachers who came to work every day on purpose with a purpose. They didn't just come for the check. They didn't just come just to be here. They came to work every day on purpose with a purpose. My high school principal, Miss Eaton, used to tell me every day that I was awesome. Now, you got to understand, I grew up in the hood, and black kids don't walk around going, "Hey, Leroy, you're awesome." I didn't even know what that meant, but I knew it meant something good, but she said it so much, I started to believe it. She said I was amazing. I said, "I'm not Spider-Man." She gave me my first birthday party when I was 12 years old, and I went from making straight Fs to being on the honor roll my sophomore, junior, and senior year, to being the first one to graduate from college in my family. My high school coach, he drove me to one of the richest areas, and the houses was huge, and he said, "You can live in a house like that." And I said to myself, if I really believe these teachers, if I really believe them, then my children don't have to grow up like I did. They'll grow up in a better neighborhood. They'll go to better schools. They'll talk different. "Father, Father, were you poor, Father? Did you eat the government cheese, Father? Were you constipated, Father? Were you a Negro, Father?" It changed my life. My children sound like they're from England. "Daddy, me wee wee and me britches, cheerio." It changed my life. It changed my life. And see, people ask this question like, why do you do what you do? And see, some of you may be saying, you know what, Melvin? Just recently, I used to go to a town called Midland, Texas. And Midland, Texas is so flat, you can see your dog run away for 2 weeks. And they called me in this school because they had a lot of problems at the school, and I started speaking at the school, and there was a town right next to it called Odessa. Now, in Odessa, they'll hug you before they mug you and stab you before they grab you. And they called me, they said, "We need your help." And I said, "You know what? Send me to the hardest school. Send me to the worst school." And they said, "You know what? We're going to send you to a school called Hood." And they go, I said, "You know what? That's where I'm from." So I go into the school, and I'm speaking to the students just like this. And after the assembly was over, there was two boys, a Hispanic boy and a Hispanic girl. The boy had a black eye. And he said, "Every day my dad tells me I'm a piece of S." And I'm not talking about Superman, even though it was a good movie. "Every day my dad tells me I'm a piece of S." And some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. You go home and you hear those negative words all the time. If you're a boy, you come to school, you're angry. You start punching walls. You even punch Barbie. "Why?" Barbie in the black eye. "I just want to love Ken." The girl was the most interesting story. The girl, she had her head down. She was crying. She said her dad left her in second grade. Her mom remarried in third. In fourth grade, her stepfather told her mother, "I'll stay with you if you let me with the daughter." And you'd have thought the mother would have said no, but the mother said yes. And so for the next 4 years, this fourth grade girl who's now in eighth grade had just got out of the hospital for the fourth time trying to commit suicide. And I walked up to this girl. I don't know this girl. I don't have a daughter. I got two boys. And I said, "Walk up to this girl." I said, "I don't have a daughter. But if I had a daughter and if she was like you, I would be a proud father." And see, sometimes we make life so hard. It's just simple words. We don't even understand how to just build people up. But see, the question is, see, some of you may be saying, "Melvin, I hear what you're saying. You know, when I go home to divorce, I go home to abuse, it's really hard to come to school and get motivated." Even some of you teachers, maybe some of you teachers may be saying, "You know what, some of these kids are getting on my left nerve. I'm ODing on Tylenol like it's gummy bears." And you may be at the point where you want to give up. I hope you don't, because that kid was me. And because you didn't give up, 8 million kids and counting have been touched, changed, and inspired, not because of what Dwayne Wade did, not because of what LeBron James did, because of what you do. And maybe you don't hear that, but I stopped by from Houston, Texas, the only place you can find 10 brothers and a white dude who can't play football, to stop by here to tell you we appreciate what you do. But some of you may be saying, "You know what, Melvin, I hear you, but it's hard. It's hard." But let me tell you, you say, how can I start over? I'll tell you a real quick story. My oldest son, Seth, who's 13, but he was about 6, I love Madden. I don't know if we got any Xbox, PlayStation, but I love Madden. I am good. I'm like your principal's face. I am awesome. And I'm playing my son Seth when he was 6 in Madden, and I'm beating him. I'm like, "Who's your daddy?" And he was like, "You." You know what I mean? And I would run in his room and go, "Hey, Seth, look what I found in your pocket." "Loser!" He started crying. I'm like, "Suck it up!" You know what I mean? But from 8 to 10, he never wanted to play me. He never wanted to play me. But I found out he went on Google, and he learned how to play the game. And I came home one day. He said, "Hey, Dad, you want to play Madden?" I said, "You want some of this?" He said, "Daddy, I want all of that." So we're playing the game. First quarter, he is whooping me 35 to nothing. He's all in my face, like, who's your daddy? I'm like, you, you know what I mean? He's running to my room like, hey, dad, look what I found in your wallet. Capital One and loser! And he was all in my face. His breath was funky. He needed an Altoid, a Tic Tac, and some bubble gum. He was so condescending, I got angry. I walked away, and I accidentally tripped over the power cord. The TV cut off, the game cut off, but I plugged the TV up. I turned the TV on, and I pressed restart, and it was 0-0. And I say that to say that many of you in the first half of your life, maybe you've been getting beat down, maybe verbally, maybe emotionally, maybe even physically, but every day is a new day to press restart. I don't care what you did yesterday, every day is a new day to press restart. I don't care if you cuss more than Snoop Dogg, every day is a new day to press restart. Let me give you just an example. Let me get the guy right here. Can you come in from real quick? You? No, it's no tricks, it's just real easy. You're not gonna be by yourself. Because you look cool, dude. Just one, need three guys. Yeah, can I get you, it's real easy. Let me get this guy here. Can he come up? Can somebody just pull his arm up? Yeah, can you pull his arm? Yeah, come on, yeah, red shoes, here we go, yeah. So I got my man here. Can I get the girl here? And then the little girl here, can I get you two? Okay, so you're gonna get on this side, red shoes, okay? Okay, you're gonna come right here. You could hit somebody with that. Oh my God, okay, that was a Pocahontas. Okay, then you're gonna come right here. Yes, let me get my man here. Dr. Dre, you're gonna come right here. Yeah, straight out of Perkins, right here. Okay, all right, so we got, okay, Dr. Dre, okay, Pocahontas. Can I get Kim Kardashian? Yes, it's real easy. It's simple. It's really easy. It's not hard. I promise. It's no tricks. Yeah. Okay. She got, okay, makeup on fleek. Okay, right here. Okay. Let me get, coach. Let me get coach. Yeah, coach. Yeah. This is going to be good. All right, coach. Is my hair okay? Okay. So, how many of you here believe that words are powerful? Words can build you up. They can tear you down. I want to motivate you too, teachers. You'll get what I'm saying. So we don't pretend. Just pretend with me. We're just pretending, all right? This is
Edgar.
He is the number one football player in the state. Who's your daddy? Number one football. Not only is he a great athlete, 98% of the student body thinks he's cool. He's also a man of power and influence, and he's also a good-looking brother. You know what I mean? This is
Angel.
Angel, but he's not an angel. But anyway, this is Angel. Angel is the number one soccer player. Oh, my knee! But he's good. Not only is he a great soccer player, 98% of the student body thinks he's cool. He's also a man of power and influence, and he's also a good-looking brother, right? It's real easy to love these two guys. They're good in sports, men of power and influence. This is?
Sonia.
Sonia is the number one midget wrestler in the world. SpongeBob Plankton, she beat him down. Gargamel, get some. Not only is she a great athlete, 98% of the student body thinks she's cool, her hair smells like Pantene, and she's awesome. This is?
Marisol.
Marisol is the number one cheerleader. She got skills. Not only is she a great athlete, 98% of the student body thinks she's cool, she's also a woman of power and influence, and it's real easy to love these two girls. Real easy to love these two guys, but this is Coach?
Martinez.
But nobody likes Coach Martinez. He farts all the time. He eats his boogers. Nobody likes fart boy. Real easy to love these two girls. Woman of power and influence, this is?
Ruby.
But nobody likes Ruby. Ruby has hairy armpits. Look like she got two black dudes in an afro and a headlock. So what happens? They tease Coach Martinez in sixth grade. Everybody's throwing boogers at him. My eye! They're teasing Ruby in seventh grade. What's up, hairy armpit girl? The only reason we like you because we can snick Snicker bars in your armpit when we go to the movie. Yeah. They're doing drive-by farts on Mr. Martinez. You know what I mean? They tease him in the eighth, ninth, tenth. True story. See, me and my wife, we get into this argument. I'm going to say something for you girls. Me and my wife, we get into this argument the other day because she tells me, don't give girls celebrity names because girls take things negative. If a guy says a girl looks like Kim Kardashian, I'm not talking about her character. I'm talking about her face. So I'm driving to Dallas, Texas to speak to a school like this, right? And I get to the school and I see the principal. She didn't look as good as Miss Hernandez. It's hard for me to stay focused with Miss Hernandez right there because I can smell her breath right here. And I go to the school and all the kids are coming in just like you did. I'm high-fiving you and all that stuff. And so if you remember the little girl that I spent the ball on her finger, okay, the same thing I did with that girl, I did the same thing with this girl at another school in Dallas. The assembly was over, they left, the principal came back, she was crying, boogers and snot was everywhere. I was gonna hug her, but I didn't want that on my arm, you know what I mean? And she goes, how did you know to pick that girl? And I said, that girl looked like Dora the Explorer. She said, well, that girl is gonna fail third grade for the second year in a row, and she's missed 18 days of school. And I said, well, can I go to her class? She goes, you would do that? I go, yeah, we go to the class. The little girl comes out, she's hugging me. And she said, you said more positive words to me in 4 minutes than my mom and dad have said to me my whole life. She digs in her pocket, she pulls out this note. I thought it was her Instagram name. It was her suicide note for that night. And see, the reason I say that is because all you kids, you're coming to school every day. You're walking past Mr. Martinez. You're walking past Dr. Dre. You're walking past El Cuto. You're walking past Pocahontas. You're walking past Ruby with the smile and the dimples. But how many times do you guys go up to your teacher and you just say, Mr. Martinez, thank you for all that you do. We really appreciate you, man. He might be hard, like machismo, but he'll go home. Go up to Miss Hernandez and say, Miss Hernandez, you want a kiss? She goes, what? And you give her a Hershey's kiss. Here. It's not like that, Miss Hernandez. You and Mr. Melvin, not us. Here's a kiss. How many of you go up to this lady right here, Jennifer Aniston? Yeah, and just with that smile. Walk up to her and say, you know what? We really appreciate everything you do. This lady here, Miss Awesome, she's freezing right now. Like, ooh, hurry up, black man, it's cold. How many of you guys go up to this guy? This guy right here, when I came in, he gave me the mic. I said, thank you, man, I appreciate that. I was gonna kiss his feet, but I saw him, he had corns. I was like, no. So I'll just kiss his calf. How many of you go up to these teachers, like, just teachers, like, Miss Chavez. Miss Chavez had some stuff going on in her family. How many people just walk by and just say, you know what, we appreciate what you do, and just hug her? She'll be all hard, like, you. When you leave, she'll go, oh my God. So we need to tell people how much we appreciate it. Give them up for my kids. Thank y'all so much. Thank you, Coach. Y'all can sit back. Thank you so much. Appreciate it, Ruby. And all right, now, three quick things, and I'll be out of your hair like I'm out of mine. Some of you will get that later. But I asked this question. I don't know if any of you ever asked this question, why? You ever asked this question, like, why? Like, why would my dad beat my mom? Why would my dad beat his kids? Like, why would my dad leave? Like, what would make a mom not tell her own son she loves him? I said, I don't know if you ever asked those questions. I started asking those questions, and I wanted to find out. So I did some investigation, and I went in incognito. And I found out that my daddy's daddy had been married 8 times. That brother was a pimp for real. And what kids see, they practice. What they practice, they become. My grandfather had been married 8 times. So you know what? My uncle cheated. He died with his third wife. My daddy cheated. 2 of my brothers have just divorced their third wife, and my one brother get high so much we call him stay high. My brother threw his own son out of a driving car. My nephew was in a coma for 11 months. My mom's dad was an alcoholic and a gambler. He beat my mother's mother all the time. My mother's mother worked 3 jobs so she wouldn't have to deal with the affairs and the abuse. So you know what? My 4 uncles are gamblers, drugs, just like their dad. 3 of my 4 aunts all married abusive men, the same men they said they would never marry when they were little girls like you. But when you don't forgive, you carry it on to the next generation. But see, me, I learned how to press restart. And in 5th grade, when I came home and I saw my mom's back broke and she was bleeding, from that moment, I said, you know what? I'll never hit a woman in my life. Now, I've been in some crazy relationship, like, hey, baby, what's up? You know what? You're crazy. I'm going to marry Miss Hernandez. But in 5th grade, I started writing poems to my wife. And when I say this story, I hope this story really motivates you girls that you never settle for nothing less than the best. And I don't care if he has abs of steel, because eventually abs of steel will become abs of meals. So this is how I asked my wife to marry me. I hope you young ladies, you hear this real clear, because all of you girls here, you are queens. So I wrote these poems to my wife. These poems to this woman I never met. Poems like, "Where you at? I miss you. I'm cuter than Miss Martinez." I mean, they were poems. And I came home after my first year with the Globetrotters. I'm signing autographs, and Sonia, that's my wife. Now, you got to understand, my wife is so black, she can put her fingerprints on charcoal. You know you black if you can wear yellow lipstick and look like a cheeseburger. You know you black if you can drive a motorcycle and get pulled over for windows too tinted. But my wife is fat, P-H-A-T, pretty hot and tempting. And I'm signing autographs, and Sonia walked by, and I said, "The Lord is my shepherd, he know what I want." And I followed into this Barnes & Noble's, and I started talking to her, and I was like, "Listen, do you have a boyfriend?" She said, "No." I said, "How long have you had that problem? Don't settle for a kid's meal when you can get a value pack. Don't get a hamburger when you can get a Big Mac." After she slapped me, I gave her my phone number, you know what I mean? And she was different than any girl I've ever dated. She'll walk into a room and it was dark and it was one light on her. Actually, it was like two because she real black. You couldn't see her. Like. And I'm beginning to realize she was the one. So I retired from playing professional sports. I took her to a beach in Galveston, Texas. I put a white piano on the beach. I got 11 of my best friends. I gave them all white tuxedos, gave each of them one white rose. And as I played her song, each guy brought a rose. We took a helicopter to a tall building downtown Houston. I had a table set up. She liked Subway sandwich, 6-inch turkey on wheat, everything but bell pepper. She liked her coffee black like her man, one equal. I know my girl, you know what I mean? I put the ring in the sandwich. She didn't eat it, but she said yes. So the next day, I took her to the movie, and I bought 3,000 roses. And while we're waiting for the movie to come on, all these guys start bringing the roses. I said, "Hey, who gave you the roses? Was it Mr. Martinez? Because you know he got jungle fever." So act like I was mad. I walked in front of the movie theater. I grabbed the mic. Now I've spoken in front of 8 million people. I don't get nervous. But I was sweating like Mike Tyson in a spelling bee contest, you know what I mean? And I said, "I want to thank my girlfriend, my fiance, for saying yes. It's been 15 years, 10 months, 16 days, 10 hours, 12 minutes, about 39 seconds. I mean, it was a great moment. And I want to tell you young girls, don't ever settle for nothing less than the best, because you girls, you're beautiful, not just on the outside, you're beautiful on the inside. And you teachers, you are doing an awesome job." It's going to be the Latino NSYNC right there, baby. I love it right there. You know what I'm saying? You're doing a good job. And some of you teachers need to hear that, that you're doing a good job. Right there. I want to leave you with this. And let me get, can I get the little guy right there? Yeah, because we're the same height. Yes, come here real quick. You could probably fit in your mama purse right here, this guy. The guy right here, look at this guy. Sit on the toilet and fall in and find Dory, just right here. Okay. Now, two quick things, and I'm going to be out of your hair. But I asked you guys earlier today, I said, "What's your dream?" And you're like, "A doctor, lawyer, professional nose digger. That's what I want to do." Yeah, you know, dreams. Well, there was a 19-year-old kid who had a dream to play chess. And ESPN had put on this competition. The winner would get a round-trip ticket around the whole world. But this 19-year-old boy started doubting. And he said, "How can I beat these men that have been playing chess for 50 and 60 years? Like, they played chess with Abraham Lincoln. They helped Noah put the animals in the ark. They fart and dust comes out." What? And there are many days that I looked in the mirror at 5'8" with high heels on, trying to play a professional sport where the average height is 6'4". There are many days I looked in the mirror and I thought, maybe I don't have what it takes. Miss Hernandez probably thought the same thing when she was a little girl, coming to school on a skateboard with one wheel. And people used to say, "Hey, little girl, what do you want to be when you grow up?" She goes, "A principal." They laughed at her. They threw tortillas. Hey! Was that corn? She made some F's, she made some D's, but she didn't quit. And look at her now. She's one of the smoothest principals. Hello. Orale, muy, muy bonita. So the guy goes to the first day of competition. He won. The second day, he won. The third day, he was the national chess champion. And his first stop was to London, England. And he walks into the museum, and he looks to the right, and there was all these pictures from third world countries. And on the other side was pictures of Miss Hernandez in 3D. Oh! It was amazing. He looks in the back, and it was all these paintings. It was an oil painting of a chessboard. He was so excited he had more teeth than a dentist. He starts running in the back, and all you saw was his elbows and his butt. And he's blown away. He just won the chess competition. He sees this chessboard, but he notices to the left there's this real big muscular guy like Mr. Martinez. "Who's your daddy?" And he's reaching over the chessboard, instilling fear into his opponent. And on the other side was a little bitty boy with a tear going down his face like, and underneath it says, checkmate, or basically you lose. So he looks at the muscular guy, and he looked at the kid. But he noticed something about the game that was off. So he immediately runs outside, he gets a taxi, he says, take me where I can get a chessboard. Gets a chessboard, brings the chessboard back, puts the chessboard right in front of the chessboard that's on the oil painting, and he started making moves on his board according to what he saw to the chessboard on the oil painting. He looks at the muscular guy, he looks at the kid. He looks at the muscular guy, he looks at the kid, and he started making moves on his board according to what he saw to the chessboard on the oil painting, and he stopped. He looked at the kid in the picture and he said, don't quit, you got one more move. Don't quit, you got one more move. And I don't know, young people, I don't know what you go through. I went through a lot of things growing up as a kid. And the reason why I'm able to stand up in front of you today is because I learned a valuable lesson. I never learned how to quit. My dad learned how to quit when he was a little boy because he saw his dad quit and his daddy's daddy quit. But it doesn't matter where you come from, what matters is where you're going. And when I look at you young people, I was more excited to come here than probably you guys just having me here. I was more excited because I didn't know that your principal was going to look like that. I would come every day. But anyway, I'm going to leave you with this. Your name is?
Jose.
Jose wanted to dedicate this time of our program to the woman of his life, to you. But what we're going to do, Jose, I'm going to shoot three shots from the free throw line backwards. And three shots from about half court backwards, and you're going to get the rebound for me. You know what a rebound is? Rebound, like if it goes over there, you just go get it. Like don't let it hit those people, but hit that lady right there. That'd be good. But anybody else? Okay, so you're going to get over here, Jose. So Jose, you're going to get the rebound. So like I'm going to shoot the shot. If it goes anywhere, you're just going to get the rebound. Give it to me, all right? So you're going to go over here. You're short, okay? So here we go. So three shots. That's all I need, Jose. All right. Cool. Okay. Oh. Went right in his nose. Okay. Two more. Here we go. Oh. Good job. Good catch, Mitt Romney. Oh, okay, hold on. Okay, I'm gonna do it again. Let me see. Ma'am, what's your name right there? White jacket, what's your name? Miss Melendez? Miss Melendez? Okay, Miss Melendez, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna shoot the shot again. Jose is gonna get the rebound. If I hit it, I'm gonna kiss you. But, if I miss, you're gonna kiss me. Miss Melendez, can I ask you a question? Can I have you a question? You ever had brown sugar? Oh, hold on. Jose, come here real quick for me. Okay, Miss Melendez, double or nothing, okay. Jose, this is my first public service announcement at your school. If you stay in school and say no to drugs, you can be just like me, black. Okay, cool. The second thing, whenever you're about to kiss a good-looking lady, and I mean, you know what I mean? You always need some mints, all right? I got some gums. I need you to go like that. Okay, you need two. Your breast's kicking like Kung Fu Panda. Here we go. So this is what we're going to do, Ms. Melendez. We're going to do it again, Ms. Melendez. Jose is going to get the rebound with his funky breath. And if I hit it, I'm going to kiss you. But if I miss, you're going to kiss us. Woo-hoo! Jose. All right. Ms. Melendez. ¿Cuántos años? 21. All right, Jose, eat the mint, man, because I can smell your breath over here. Like, it's killing. Like, you're, like, going to kill that whole section right there. You got to Put one on the tip of your tongue, let it marinate. Like carne guisada. You gotta put it on it. Here we go. All right. All right, Jose, you ready? Hit it. You know, what's up?
We love you, Miss Hernandez. This doesn't change my feelings for you. You're always number one in my heart. Corazon.
Gotta give him some skin, man. There you go. There you go. All right. Real quick, before I go, I just want y'all to know that Miss Melendez's hair smelt like gummy worms. Thank you. I want to thank Jose. Eat those mints, because I can still smell your breath. You gotta use Crest or something. I don't know what you're using, but Colgate ain't working. I want to thank Mr. Martinez. He was where's Mr. Martinez? I want to thank him. When I came in, he just showed a brother some love. He hugged me, and his armpit smelled delicious. And then I got to meet his cool wife. Where's his wife? Always far away from my husband. I don't want to be around you. I want to thank her. I want to thank the coaches, all these coaches, like all what y'all do. Merv Griffin. I want to thank Debo from Friday. Give me the Beast Cruiser, man. Debo, Miss Marlenis, thank you for the kiss of life. I want to thank Taylor Swift. We knew you were trouble when you walked in. I want to thank all you teachers for doing a good job, everything you're doing. Young people, I want to leave you with this. I love you. The reason why I do what I do is because I love you. Not afraid to say it, straight from the heart, I love you. Before you go, do me two things. Do me two things before you go. My Instagram is Trotter Melvin, so you can hit me up on Instagram. I'm not good at social media, but I try every day to put up something motivating for you. Hold on. That's my girl. You work it, Miss Martinez. Work it, Miss Hernandez. Love it. Right. And also, I just want to say, I want to thank your principal, because she could have said no. When we called her to come to your school and I was flying into Harlingen, she could have said, you know what, I don't want no black man in my school. Mm-hmm. But she could have said, but you know what, she said yes. She let us come in. The lady right next to her, I forget her name, but she has just been like Mother Teresa and Martin Luther King rolled in a tortilla as a woman. Just been awesome. And I want to thank, yes, yes. And and I want to say, listen, doesn't matter where you come from, what matters where you're going. Don't quit. You always have one more move. Thank you so much. Appreciate it, guys. Have a great day. Thank you so much.